During the verification and validation workflow, it is absolutely crucial to test your components. You want to test your components to make sure that they meet your requirements. So the first thing to do is to perform unit testing. Unit testing consists in isolating your components, which we will call component under tests, and then inject some test inputs. Test inputs can be injected manually with dashboards, or maybe you can just use pre-recorded signals. The same thing can be done to test the results. You can use dashboards, or maybe you can automate the process with some verifying assessments. So let's see how this works in practice. So we go back to our Simulink model, we go back to the state machine. And then from here, what we need to do, we need to go to the Simulink tool strip, and then we need to create from here a test harness. So to do this, we select Simulink Test. And then after selecting Simulink Test, we can create a test harness by clicking on Add Test Harness. We can give a name to this test. We can specify location of the harness. And then we can specify different ways to excite our system. We can use import, we can use signal builder, signal editor from workspace, and so on. So in this case, we select signal builder. And then same can be done for the outputs. So we can select scope to workspace to files. In this case, we select scope. So after doing this, we click on OK. And this will automatically create the test harness for us. So here you can see the signal builder. Here you can see the model reference, which actually links to the component under test. And then here we have the scope. So at this point, we can make the model a bit more tidy. So we select the components, we go to the format tab, and then we adjust the model a little bit. So if you click on the signal builder, you will find all the signals injected to the system and that you will need to either import or manually modify. If you click on the badge on the bottom right, you can come back to the component under test, and the same can be done from the component under test. You click on the badge and you can find all the test harnesses that you have created. And in this way, you can go back and forth. Okay. So I have previously created a test harness where I use dashboards to manually test my component. So I select this harness, and then from here, if I open this subsystem, I show different dashboard blocks that I can use to manually test my component. So I run a simulation, and then from here, I can manually inject some test inputs. So I change the cell voltage to 6, and then I can see that there is a fault given by the controller. So when I stop the simulation, I could come back to the MATLAB workspace and I can find a simulation output variable. So this simulation output variable contains a dataset, which I'm now calling my fault scenario. And here you can find all the signals that you have logged in the test harness, with the path, the name, and the values. So now we can perform another test. So we go back to the test harness, we go back to the dashboard subsystem. Maybe we change back to the same value as before. We run a simulation, we change some other inputs, and then we can see that now we are simulating another fault. We stop the simulation, we go back to the MATLAB workspace, and then once again, we get the dataset. We give it another name, and this is very important because now I can save these datasets into a MAT file. And this is very convenient because we can record test inputs and then we can play them back. And this can be done, for instance, if you create another test harness
and you inject signals through another block, which is a signal editor. So from the signal editor, you can select the MAT file that contains all the datasets that you have recorded. And indeed, if you open this block, you can find all the datasets that you have previously recorded, and they contain all the signals. Of course, you can visualize these signals to see what they look like, but then you can even add other datasets. So for example, you can duplicate one of the existing ones, you can modify the test inputs, you apply the modifications, and you can find that now you have another test input. So after you do this, you can select any of these scenarios that you have recorded, and then you can run the simulations, and then you can verify the behavior of your component.